Hello everyone, I'm Steve Stallard with Johnson Plastics Plus, and today I'm joined with Aaron Stout. Some of you folks, if you have equipment with us or have purchased equipment or call us for help, you've talked with Aaron. Aaron is on our advanced support team. So if you buy an iColor 250, you'll be likely to talk to him or one of the other members about this. So we're gonna do an unboxing today, and Aaron and myself are gonna walk you through that process. And if you've bought any product from Uninet and iColor, you know how simple they make this. They do a great job of labeling everything within the box and telling you what to remove and walking you through that setup. So we're gonna just go through this like you have just got this at home. So let's tackle this, Aaron.
All right,
so we've got this iColor 250 here. And one of the things, why don't you talk about the sheet that Uninet provides on the printers with their quick start setup guide.
Yeah, so one of the things that Uninet's really good with is giving you step-by-step instructions on how to set up the printers. If you just go by each step, it's usually pretty easy, usually pretty pain-free, and usually you can get it up and running relatively quickly.
All right, perfect. So again, in the box here, you've got this guide. You want to hang on to this quick start guide. It's going to have your iColor custom cut activation code that's on here and then also on the bottom of the printer. So this is going to be important. You're going to need that when you activate the software, and you'll need it again just in case you move it to another PC. So one of the first things we're going to pull out here says, remove me first. Okay, so big white label, red lettering. Start with this box. Aaron has here, and he's pulled this from our website, the instruction manual. This is page 6, and it's going to go through packaging and inspection of the parts within this box just to make sure you have everything. Again, on the quick start guide, it's here two pictures, but it's not labeled. So Aaron's going to discuss what all this is and how it works with the printer here.
Yep, so with this list, it has everything numbered, everything's kind of spelled out for you, so it's good to go over everything just to make sure nothing's broken, there's no damage to any of the parts.
Absolutely.
So the first thing on the list is a power cord. So it's inside the white box here, just a simple power cord that plugs into the printer. The number 2 on here is the 6-foot USB cord. You might want to remember that this printer is only USB compatible, right?
That is correct. Ethernet, yep.
So it's just a USB cord there. Number 3 on here is the color dye ink cartridge.
That's actually going to be in the printer. They've changed that up a little bit. It's actually going to be in the printer here, and you'll see when you pull the printer out and you flip the lid, your ink cartridge is going to be sitting right on top.
So the next on the list here is the is a knife holder, and then the USB with the software included. And then you also get in this little package here, you have an Allen wrench and a couple screws to help with the installing the knife. So the next on here is the label roll holders. We have right here, right?
Yep, these are gonna be your legs and your label roll holders. They're gonna help stabilize the printer. That's what the roll of the media is gonna sit on.
All right, those. And then we also have the large roll hub and a small roll hub. So that's these two here.
And that's gonna cover everything that's within the package for you to get started. So again, in your instructions, it's gonna tell you how you wanna start putting these together. It shows here on the picture. You're gonna attach the two legs with the roll holder. It shows here with that. You're gonna use the Allen wrench and the screw for that. And it's a really simple process. And again, if you just follow these, or you can download the user instruction manual, walk you through that. If you have any questions, you can definitely give us a call. We'll be glad to help you with that. Let's go ahead and move on to the next part of this installation. So we've already inspected all the additional parts with the printer. We've set those off to the side. So now let's actually get this printer out of the box. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab it here.
Thank you
for your help. Appreciate that. Lots of packing material here. I'll just let Aaron kind of go ahead and get started and pulling everything apart here.
So another good thing that Uninet does with their printers is they kind of label the tape. They have either orange or blue tape, and you just wanna make sure that you take all the tape off. Do you want to go through
this
whole thing?
Yep.
Okay, so we're just going to undo the tape here, bring it out of the bag.
Oh, I'll help you.
You can see the blue tape is on the front. Remove that.
Just making sure you grab all this. You'll see exactly where everything is. Some of it's here trapped here on the side. There we go.
So on the inside here, they have some foam. You want to make sure to remove that.
The one thing I want to touch on too, if you're referencing the owner's manual, it's going to show that your ink cartridges is in that is in the cardboard box that you get with it. It's actually not. It's going to be sitting in here in the system. And this is the dye-based ink cartridge that you're going to get with this. And again, there's dye and pigment ink, and you can swap in between, but this is the dye-based cartridge that comes with this. And again, this will show you on your cartridge insulation tip here some directions for you. Again, another great tool by Uninet that they put on a lot of their products here. Go ahead, Aaron.
And then the last thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you take the tape off of where you insert the ink to make sure that that's free.
And really simple. Once you've done that, you've moved the tape, you're going to be able next to start walking through the rest of that installation. I always recommend to download the user's manual. It's going to walk you for everything A to Z. That's going to be on our website. When we help you install that, we're going to reference that and have you download that so it's readily available for you. It's got a great walkthrough. It's going to walk you through setting up the legs, installing the ink cartridge, installing the software. But this here just getting going to give you an idea of unboxing your printer, what to expect, how you're going to walk through those items. And again, we're going to help you with every printer you purchase from Johnson Plastics Plus. We're going to help you and assist you through that installation process and help you configure the software. So again, thanks for joining myself, Steve Stallard, Johnson Plastics Plus, and Aaron Stout from our advanced support team. And if you have any questions, feel free to always give us a call and we'd be glad to help you.